revenue. And then we'll take it higher. Oh, we're gonna rock down to Electric Avenue. And then we'll take it higher. Working so hard like a soldier. Can't afford a thing on me.
15.
The 18th of January, 1981, in a house party not too dissimilar to this one. Yvonne Roddick and Angela Jackson's birthday party at 439 New Cross Road. It goes all throughout the night into the early hours of the morning. There were some noise complaints. Things have been pretty tense around the neighborhood. The far right started closing in, and really, no one knows how the fire started. Words on everyone's lips.
A car was seen speeding away.
Suspicion, but no investigation.
No charge.
There were some survivors.
Although, they didn't last very long.
The total cost?
In the end, 13 dead.
And nothing said.
13 dead.
Nothing said.
Heart of Brixton, a place where everyone could go without fear of harassment or judgment. A place we could call our own. Booze, liquor, weed, everything that went down in Railton Road. You see these two boys, Benjamin and Nicholas? They didn't exist. But boys like them existed all over Brixton. Boys that were heartbroken, fearless. In that sense, Benjamin and Nicholas existed all over Brixton.
Yo, Nicholas, how you doing, man?
I'm good. How about you?
Man's just been living his best life, you get me?
All you can do around here. Good to see you, girl.
Yo, is that you, Nicholas, yeah? What are you telling me? Talk to me. You said it.
I'm not what?
It's Rebel Road, the first man touches up in here.
Uh-huh. Well, what do you want? Didn't you see my friend over here when you walked here?
Don't stress, Bridget, I'm all right.
I'll go on. Push it custom. Jimmy, I'm sorry about that.
Don't stress, we've all got to eat.
You got a job?
Ain't no man got a job around here no more.
Come work with me in the front lines.
Nah, Nicholas, that's your thing. Ain't about that.
Fair, no problem. Just trying to help.
Appreciate it still. I've got a job interview tomorrow.
Oh yeah? Where?
Just a corner shop up in Central.
They want you up there.
Dunno, but it's the best I've found in a long time.
And that picture, should I see?
That Nicholas.
When's my baby girl gonna let me take her dancing?
You still not getting over that?
Never.
Have you gotten over dealing? you know I'm looking for a man with prospects.
I ain't got prospects. Man's making a livelihood out here. Can get my baby girl whatever she wants. You want a new coat? Just say the word.
So you think you can buy me?
I expect my lady to feel special.
And who says I'm your lady?
Oh, we still play this game, because I think it's common.
Oh, Nicholas, you should go. Your friend's getting away with you.
What is that for?
You're playing idiot. Lady's not interested.
Just for that. Lay the charms on her.
Bertrand, you've been laying the charms on Patricia for 5 years.
Girl like that's worth 5 more.
You seen this?
Seen what?
It's about New Cross.
The fire.
You see, if it wasn't already obvious, the New Cross victims had something very particular in common.
It's a protest.
The Black People's Day of Action.
10 a.m, March 2nd.
Scotland Yard, House of Commons and 10 Downing Street.
About time someone said something about that, I say. It's been 2 months.
And not one arrest.
Oh, there's been arrests, just not to do with the fire.
Blame the sus for that.
I'm going.
Me too.
With the feds cracking down like they are. Nah, might be dangerous. My girl should just...
I'm not your girl and I'm going.
How many people do you think are actually going to turn up?
It doesn't matter. So long as one person shows up, we'd have made a statement.
People will show up.
And how can you be sure?
Because I know there's enough men out there sick of how we've been treated out here.
And now our children are paying the price.
It's safe to say that more than one person showed up. The total turnout, 20,000.
Of us here united in one cause.
Justice! Justice for the blood of the youth spilled!
Unity! Unity against the oppression we all face!
Because New Cross was the spark.
But the oil was spilled a long time ago.
Back when our parents were promised a land of opportunity.
Of freedom!
My mother tells me what it felt like to be on that boat. Propelled by the rush of the wind, how it felt to come home to the motherland. She tells me that before she came here, she thought the streets were paved with diamonds, and the sky glistened and sparkled like a summer's day every day. Childish things, like how everybody would have their own job to work, and their own food to eat, and their own place to sleep. How she'd watch her children grow up to be doctors and lawyers. How everybody would have their own place to belong. And if you were ever in trouble, you could just run up to a police officer on the street and say, "Hey, I need help." And everything would be okay. Like I said, childish things.
I saw that interview on TV. You know the one, everybody saw it. When our Prime Minister, the leader of Great Britain, went on national TV and said,
"By the end of the century, there should be 4 million people of the new Commonwealth of Pakistan here. Now that is an awful lot. And I think, Niels, people are really rather afraid that this country might be rather swamped by people with a different culture. And you, now, the British character, has done so much for democracy, for law, and done so much throughout the world, that if there is any fear that it might be swamped, people are going to be out rather hostile."
An awful lot rather swamped with people from a different culture. The thing is, I thought we were all one and the same. I mean, we were invited here, our mums and dads, only now to be told that the country might be rather swamped. It's just, the British character has done so much for but it can't handle it when the world wants a little back. And hostile, she's right there. People are going to act rather hostile. Because if it isn't for the far right, the white supremacists, then it's the politicians. You know, before New Cross, before first young people burned in a house fire.
It was reported that Birmingham Conservative MP Jill Knight said that a stand should be taken against so-called
noisy black house parties.
So, I guess we should have been surprised by what happened next. You know, it's funny, I do break the law. I sell. Not much else for me to do around here. Not like anybody's hiring. Or at least, not like anybody's hiring people who look like me. And despite that, that never seems to be the reason why I'm arrested, that I'm stopped. I remember out on the underground once, Oxford Circus Station, changing trains to get to Brixton, when these two men grabbed me and said, "We are arresting you in suspicion of pickpocketing of persons unknown." Persons unknown. Didn't even need a victim, a reason. Well, I guess they did have a reason. They didn't end up arresting me in the end. Just roughed me up a bit and left me there like dirt on their oversized boots.
When interviewed about the relationship between local black youths and police around the time of the riot, former London Met police officer Peter Blexley had this to say.
"We were racist."
That's enough said, really.
The day the blacks ran riot printed front page on a national newspaper. That was supposed to be a peaceful protest. That was us exercising our rights.
Our rights.
Do you think this is a joke?
A little bit, yeah. I mean, since when did you think them men up there cared about our rights?
Well, the joke's on me, I guess.
Wait, Patricia, Patricia, look at me.
What is this? A mockery.
Change. This is a national newspaper, and we made it on there. 20,000 of us marching.
Rioting.
You and me both know this was no riot. But who cares what they say it was? Hell, they say it was a riot. Maybe it should have been.
You don't mean that.
Don't I? Imagine it. 20,000? Try 50,000 marching right up to the House of Parliament, sticks and stones.
Oh yes, and show them that they're the thugs that we think they are. That's a great idea.
I'm just saying that peace may not always be an option.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Huh?
Nicholas,
I think you know what that means. Patricia, let's go.
We ain't done nothing.
Oh, you know that don't matter.
Good evening, sir. Ma'am.
Officers. And, what are you two doing out this time of night?
We were just out, getting something to eat.
I see you've read the newspaper.
Yes, sir.
Quite the, commotion your lot caused.
Our lot?
Bless.
We were just exercising our rights for a peaceful protest like everybody else.
And tell me, what exactly was it you were protesting?
The New Cross massacre?
I haven't heard any massacre in New Cross. Have you, officer?
Why, no, I haven't.
House fire. 12 young people died.
12 young black people?
Yes.
I didn't hear about that. It's very sorry to hear. It was an accident though, wasn't it?
Well, I don't know, you tell me.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Well, I believe it falls under your jurisdiction to investigate such matters.
Well, if no evidence has been found linked to any sort of wrongdoing, then I guess it must have been a plain old house fire. It was a birthday party, right? Maybe the candle fell off the cake.
A car was seen speeding away from the crime scene.
And maybe it was just passing by. Are you meant to investigate every car that goes nearby a crime scene?
Well, yes, I believe that's called due diligence.
And I believe it's called being quiet.
You. Got anything on you?
Nah, nothing.
Nothing dangerous? Drugs, weapons.
My tongue's pretty sharp.
Funny.
Nicholas!
Put a step back to Dom.
Stay down, boy! Alright, on your knees. Hands behind your head.
Nothing.
And I don't usually bring weapons on dates.
Oh, shut up, Nicholas!
Now the lady's got the right idea.
Nothing left to say?
Nicholas!
It's fine. I'm fine.
There's that word again. Swamp. The objective was simple.
10 squads of plainclothes police officers deployed across Brixton.
The objective? To stop and search any black youths they saw.
Even on Elton Road.
And how was this legal, if you're wondering?
The sus law.
Peaceable 19th century legislation found under the Vagrancy Act 1824, section 4, every suspected person or reputed thief frequenting any river, canal, or navigable stream, dock, or basin, or any key wharf or warehouse near or adjoining thereto, or any street, avenue, or highway leading thereto, or any place of public resort, or any avenue leading thereto, or any person with intent to commit an arrestable offence shall be named a rogue and vagabond, and found guilty of an offence should be liable for up to 3 months imprisonment. Meaning?
As long as you're in public ground.
We can arrest you for any damn reason at all.
955 people were stopped and searched over the following 5 days, with 82 arrested. It had been around a month since the Black People's Day of Action, and tensions were running higher than they ever had before.
Hello, sir! Sir, can I tell me your name?
Michael Bailey.
Hello, sir. Dispatch! There's been assault on Atlantic Road! Young black youth! Large stabbed wound! Requesting support!
What the hell is going on here?
You need to step back.
What's the situation?
Stabbing. Three youths seen went running away from the scene.
Is he going to be okay?
I said step back!
Are you going to stand there or are you just going to help him?
Dispatch! Immediate attention required!
Sir, Michael, I'm going to need you to talk to me. I need you to talk to me.
He's bleeding!
We need to get him back to the car, now!
What's going on?
Benjamin,
he's... For God's sakes, we all get back! Now!
Don't worry about us! Worry about him! Look at him!
He's dying!
Come and get him up!
With tension so high, even the slightest misunderstanding was bound to turn this bar into a flame. Benjamin, Nicholas, Patricia, they weren't really there.
But when they saw the amassing crowd and three police officers standing over a bleeding body, there was only one possible outcome.
Assist the bird! Killing him!
In the aftermath of the violence, Bristol Police Commander Lord Fairbairn called a local meeting with local community leaders to quell tensions.
I called you all to this meeting to discuss the incident that happened this morning on the Atlantic Road.
And by incident, you mean complete and utter disgrace.
Well, yes, yeah, I do. I'm glad to see we're on the same page here.
Three officers were attacked by violent thugs.
And the young man was left to bleed to death on the street.
I would like to inform you that Michael Bailey is safe and well. He's recovering in a hospital as we speak, no thanks to those foul miscreants.
Well, word is spreading around Brixton like wildfire that that young boy is dead.
Misinformation, Carl.
Don't you see? An entire community believes a young man is dead. Hell, I've heard some believe you stabbed the boy yourselves.
Murder, murder! Police stab up local youth!
Ridiculous.
Maybe, but can you blame them?
What's that supposed to mean?
Swamp 81, I beg of you, stop it before it's too late.
This again?
Yes, this again. Did you see the hurt you're causing? The pain, the panic. This community is...
The black community, Mrs. Leon. Brixton is a community of colors and types. Our duty is to protect all the people of Brixton.
So you admit it. Swamp? The sus, it's intended to target black communities.
It's intended to protect the little old lady walking down the street from having to clutch her handbag at night, no matter her shape.
But if you continue with this course of action, the consequences, they could be...
They could be what? Is this a threat?
Would you take us seriously if we said that it was?
If we withdraw now, we will be seen as surrender. The London Metropolitan Police cannot be seen bowing down to the agitations of some black radicals. We have a responsibility not only to Railton Road, but the people of Brixton.
You have a duty to protect the people, not persecute them.
Swamp 81 is not going to be deterred.
Thank you.
It's on fire. I have no time to discuss who said what or when.
The only way to defuse the situation is to decrease the police presence in the area at the current moment. They see the police as their enemy.
I understand exactly what you're saying, and I appreciate all that you've done, but there's no question in removing the police from here.
Why? Your pride? Too ashamed to admit defeat?
It's not a defeat.
How many police officers have been injured? 50? How many cars burned? Please, this has to stop. There's still a chance for peace, a slim chance, but a chance. We have to take it.
I'm not giving.
Then Brixton will burn.
Say so! You've got this guy! I'm not going to keep your word and do our thing.
Self-defense.
This is arson. The day the blacks ran riots, remember that? Because it's true.
What's done is done.
So we should have stood by and let the sus consume us, huh?
There are ways of fighting entirely that don't involve destroying everything you love. Look, you've burned down the old neighborhood. Just look. We did this, not them. How can you not feel shame? Everything we fought to protect is in ruins.
No. The people, they had this coming. The people, they're going to see what we've been through. They're going to notice.
Well, at what cost?
Patricia.
Right, Nicholas.
Not since the 1780 Gordon riots have Britain's streets seen such disorder. Almost 300 police officers and 45 rioters were injured. The death toll? Zero, somehow. The police blamed the riots on so-called black radicals.
There weren't just locals in Brixton, but others from elsewhere had come to help. This wasn't spontaneous, this was planned.
Locals disagree.
Do we seem like organized people? Radicalists? Racists?
And the government seemed all too happy to deny any and all wrongdoing.
Nothing. Nothing justifies what happened on Saturday night, and I cannot condemn it too strongly.
It's when Thatcher's Home Secretary, William Whitelaw, excuse the irony, was sent to see what was what about Brixton, he vowed to launch a public inquiry. The Scarman Report, commissioned by the UK government, inscribed by Honourable Lord Scarman, was an official report on the Brixton riots. Police work done according to the consent of the people and police in Brixton had since lost such consent, and in future would have to work in accordance with the local community, not against. The police was encouraged to hire more black and Asian officers into the force, and in the August of 1981, the SUS was repealed.
London to new class. How can there be justice when the bombers are the bars? 13 young lives wasted, their practice way of life. And if you walk the streets, them want to stab you with a knife. We will not forget, no, we must not forget. 13 dead and nothing said, we will